So we'll move on to my next topic is almost the same, the chronic infection management. Here, there are problems whenever we come across some chronic infections, difficulty in diagnosis. Sometimes when the patient comes to you already for a month, they would have been on many of the antimicrobial agents, and then we have to think what it could be. Non-availability of specific antimicrobial agents for some of these infections, and inflammatory and toxic reactions are more here than the infection itself, and the prolonged course, the economical and the complaints problem of the for the patient also. So let us see a few case examples. This is a patient, a 50-year-old female, a diabetic, euthyroid, and her poor glycemic control. She came with a referred from her center. She was on treatment for a bilateral viral keratitis for almost 8 months. Then towards the end, suddenly she started developing one eye, complete necrosis, like in the cornea become a necrotic thing. So they refer her immediately to us. And they have done some basic microbiological workup. They suspected some bacterial infection, but then it was not responding to any of the treatment. So the stroma was that initial picture I don't have for that right eye. Initially, the patient was on this treatment, basically. So what we did, we went for confocal microscopy, and also from the history and from the look of the other eye, we suspected microsporidial infection, because many times a chronic non-responding viral keratitis, we have to keep this in mind. And then we found this typical bright bodies in the confocal, but this eye was very bad, so we have to go for a therapeutic keratoplasty immediately. And the pathology shows that the microorganisms like rice-like microorganisms, microsporidiosis organism, they are going up to the almost Descemet's level. So then what happened to that, for the left eye, we were closely observing her, and this is not actually her picture, this is how a microsporidial infection can present, sometimes just as a superficial punctate infection, like a viral infection itself. But the punctae will be very large, and it will be flat top, where you can easily scrape, and we can see in the smears, where we can diagnose the microsporidia. But the problem in culture, it will not grow. So the other eye was slowly, you could remember the initial picture, the other eye lesion was very small, but gradually it was increasing like this, and the typical granular cloudy appearance should raise a suspicion. So here we have been convincing her to go for corneal biopsy. It took us such a long time because one eye already, she was very not happy with that result of that eye. So finally, when we did the corneal biopsy, then we could prove that that eye also was infected by microsporidia, the deep infection. And in case of microsporidia, we have many treatment, sporadically advised, but none of them seem to work. And medical treatment for microsporidia is almost like getting a medical cure is almost nil. So we have gone for a DALK initially, a therapeutic DALK. But later again we could see that she is getting edema of the graft and some inflammation, smoldering in the anterior chamber and endothelium. Then we were scared about the recurrence. Then we went in for a TPK. And again the biopsy showed that microsporidia. So we have to keep this in mind when we are coming across obvious viral or something. A bilateral herpetic lesion is little bit rare. We have to keep that in mind. In such cases, we have to keep other possibilities, especially in our country, possibilities like microsporidia. The next case, again, another 64-year-old male with no systemic problem or anything, presented with a usual history of corneal ulcer. What we saw here, little different, is this dendritic kind of tentacle kind of infiltrations all around. So then the initial scraping did not show much. Then the culture showed this typical submerged appearance of the culture growth. And then we have to diagnose Pythium, we should have this, we have to demonstrate this microsporangia. So they have done it, and then we proved that it is Pythium. So many times we can mistaken it for simple filamentous fungi, and Pythium is a very bad prognosis. It won't respond to your antifungal infection drugs because the ergosterol is absent in its wall. So we have to, most of the time, we have some antibiotics like linazolid and other things, but most of the time they will go for surgical intervention. Again, here we went in for surgical intervention so that we can at least preserve the globe. Later, visual rehabilitation we can think about. The same thing for acanthamoeba, there are such a small ring infection, so two problems will be there. One, because of the prolonged course, the toxicity, either due to the toxins from the organism itself or your medications, the toxic reactions themselves can affect the eye very badly. Or like when you are waiting, we have to go for, the infection, if it spreads to the sclera and other things, we may lose the globe itself. So as Dr. Aikida already mentioned, if the infection is going towards the periphery, or if the infection in such, because acanthamoeba, you know, like it may, the treatment may go on even up to a year. So if the inflammation, infection is prolonging, then we have to plan for a therapeutic intervention. We should not hesitate for that. In the some stage, sometimes a case like this, where it looks like only mainly inflammatory necrosis is the main problem, we can go for even AT-DAL. But if the infection is seems to be more than involving more than the mid-stroma, we have to better to go for a therapeutic penetrating keratoplasty. But therapeutic DALK also can, in cases, it will work. So in this case, actually the reinfection did not occur, but you can see already there was cataract, and the endothelium is also not very good with studded with pigments and other things. So actually I felt like we have waited too much for this patient. We should have gone for a graft early. So later we need to go for a DSEC and cataract extraction in this case. But this is a different case which presented to us like this, with the full thickness involvement, patient post C3R infection. So then we straight away went in for therapeutic penetrating keratoplasty. Then it is shown in the histopathology that cysts were going up to the Desmond's level. And luckily this patient, the graft survived. Though it is such a large graft, it survived even after 1 year, it's remaining clear. And another problem, a prolonged course, as I told, inflammation will be a main problem. So we may need to consider steroid in these cases. But in case of acanthamoeba, initially, before diagnosis or before controlling the infection, should not go for steroid. That will be detrimental. But what we observed in another study, when we repeat the cultures, after 4 to 6 weeks, the culture become negative. So by that time, more of inflammatory reaction which is affecting the eye, at that time we can slowly introduce steroid in a low dose and maintain them, and then later you stop the steroid and continue antimicrobial, anti-amoebic agents for more time. We have done a study also and which presented we in the World Cornea Congress, and again we have shown that using steroid like that very meticulously, like, no, then like it's not increasing the TKP rate or it not decreasing the healing time. So we have to select the case and accordingly we have to do. And coming to the steroid, whether is it useful in other infections like bacteria, the SCUD study already addressed this. We have not found any usefulness of adding steroid by decreasing the scar or anything, but at the same time it is not detrimental to add once you control the infection. But and another very few points which we have to analyze in this study, like in chronic, it's a very severe infection, it's more useful. And same way, Pseudomonas, initially we were so hesitant to try steroid in Pseudomonas when we planned this study, but Pseudomonas gave actually better results with steroid. But the nocardia, almost it will behave like fungus. So in case of nocardia, it's better to avoid steroid at any cost. So in conclusion, chronic infection, when we come across, we have to keep in mind, we have to be prepared first for a prolonged treatment. The patient's compliance is very, very important. And diagnosis sometimes can be very challenging. And we have to think about the comorbidities and we have to manage them also. And surgical interventions, again, maybe most of the time will be needed because some of this infection doesn't have any proper medications. Thank you.